Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you a new version of the large chorus fruit farm I recently built on a SciCraft server and also make a tutorial on it. So this farm is based on something that Toes Redstone recently discovered. He discovered if you send in an endstone block under a chorus flower, it would cause the flower to instantly grow, as you can see here. And the concept is just chained up, so the chorus flower that is planted right here would grow 240 blocks high, and you would harvest all of those plants and get 0 to 1 fruits per plant. So we can get 120 chorus fruits per single chorus flower. So I'm just gonna turn this on quickly, and as you can see here, we're chaining this upwards, and the stems of the plant are broken, and all the chorus fruit would drop down. So this version is a little bit slower than the one I built on a SciCraft server, but doesn't matter much. It takes 24 seconds until the flower arrives at the top. And on the SciCraft we use two players, because a second player could actually break the flower at the top, and this way we could get it back. In single player it's probably not reasonable to try to break the flower at the top. It's probably a better alternative to just build a small chorus flower farm. But per invested chorus flower, you would get 120 fruit out of it. If you would grow a flower normally, so like this, then you get 12, as if you break it the stem, you just get 12 fruit on average. So it's definitely the better choice to use this farm to grow your flowers. If you have enough chorus flowers or have a second player to get them back, then you can also AFK this farm. So you can turn this on here and then the clock would start. Just have to aim at the side of the endstone block, and every 1.8 seconds you could plant a new chorus flower. So if you would AFK for 1 hour in here and wouldn't run out of flowers, then you get 240,000 chorus fruits. So all the chorus fruits will be collected by this water stream at the bottom here. There's also some loss, but it's really negligible. It's less than 1% of the fruit that would fall out to the side. If you really wanted to, you could also try to collect them somehow. Since you get so many chorus fruits, it doesn't matter much. So I just planted down 10 flowers, and we already got that. And there's still some more coming in. The farm is really lag-friendly for a farm that does so many operations per second, because the repeatable pattern doesn't involve any redstone dust. Redstone dust is really the main lag causer in any redstone contraption. Also, it's quite easy to build. It also doesn't contain any repeaters, which is a source of constant errors if you do some repeater timings wrong. So it's really easy to build as well. So you just need some pistons, observers, and redstone blocks. The purpose of those terracotta blocks is to keep the falling fruits inside of the chamber so they will be picked up by the water stream. Of course, you could use different blocks for those, just wanted to mark them. And this farm would work in 1.11. It uses some observers which were introduced in 1.11, but I built this in the first 1.12 snapshot. As you can see, I used the new concrete and terracotta blocks, but it would also work in 1.11. Alright, so now let's start the tutorial. So this is the endstone block that you place your chorus flower on. And of course you want to build this farm as low as possible, so you can build it as high as possible. It reaches up to sky limit. The higher you build, the more you get. And below that endstone block you need 3 blocks of space. So if your bedrock level would be here, then it's alright. So first of all we need a dropper that would give you the chorus flower back. So we need 2 droppers right here, and also an on switch. Just gonna add a lever right here, and you could also start adding the water stream. So we make the structure right here out of ice blocks. That's where your chorus flowers would fall on later. And now let's add the clock system. So here we need redstone dust, comparator, and repeater. And make a comparator clock. So here we have 2 repeaters, and they are in total on 18 redstone ticks. So every 18 redstone ticks we get a new signal, and we also have to power those 2 droppers that would dispense you the chorus flowers. So We're just gonna add another repeater right here. So now we could also start with the repeating piston layout. So we need to sort of tick in endstone every layer, of course, and we just alternate between left and right. So the endstone pattern would be like this. Of course, we couldn't have the endstone right here because otherwise the flower couldn't grow. That's why we need to push in the endstone with two steps. So first this piston pushes it over here and this one zero ticks it. And this piston doesn't zero tick the block because that's not really necessary. And also alternate the pistons on each side. And then also add a piston every second block right here. And I'm just gonna build those four layers, but this will repeat itself until sky limit afterwards. So now let's start with the wiring. So those pistons obviously need to push in the block, and a normal pulse is enough. So we use just a normal game tick pulse coming from an observer, and we power this block right here, and basically put an observer right here just to move the block for now, so the pistons aren't getting powered. And those observers would receive their signal from an observer tower, which we put in the back. It would go up to sky limit afterwards. And now we also need to zero tick this piston right here. We also add skip piston over there for redstone block in front. So the idea is to push in the redstone block in this position here, so it would power the sticky piston, and then in the same game tick, remove the power source again, so this piston would zero tick the endstone block. And in order to achieve that, we're gonna grab the redstone block with this piston right here, which is extended. Now we just need to add another sticky piston right here with another block in front. And basically, if this redstone block goes into that position, this will be pushed out. So as you can see here, we get a zero tick pulse with that piston. Since this one is also zero ticked, we have to send the blocks back somehow. And that's why we add an observer, which should detect this piston right here, and just some normal block. So let's put this back and do it once more. You can see here, the block is sent back. And this is great, because here the endstone block is also extended. This piston that grabs the endstone block is extended, and if I remove this redstone block again, so basically this piston grabs it again, we also get the endstone block in the position again, and then just have to grab it with this one here. So that's the whole setup really. Now we can also add that concrete block again, or whatever solid block you use. Okay, so I built this up also for the second layer on this side, and we just need to do the same for the other side. So just mirror everything over there. Maybe I'll quickly build it again for this side. So add observers right here. Maybe we have the observer tower. Then add another sticky piston right here for redstone block in front. Then here we have sticky pistons again. Those have to be sticky, by the way. And here we have the extended sticky piston. Some block here, could be any block really. And then observer in the back, which would power normal piston that sends the blocks back. And now add the concrete blocks right here, and also this side is done. Okay, now we can continue with our water stream system at the bottom right here. So we also need to add some ice blocks like this. And now we could fill in all those gaps, because obviously if you just would keep it like this, then a lot of those fruits would land in the gaps in between. So we need to add a whole lot of extra blocks just to make sure the fruits are collected. So now also let's put blocks around the water stream. Like this. And here we just use normal blocks. So this would be the wall. You would stand on top of the dropper, and then we just make this little wall. So we could place the cross fruit through there. Then we also need to expand the wall. I'm just gonna use glass for now to finish it. Now let's add the water. To go up till here. Here we can just add a slab and add a second water stream coming from here. And this would go into your storage system. Okay, now let's fill in the gaps behind it, the pistons. So here we need to fill everything up between those endstone blocks and here in the back. Those cross flowers always need one air block to the side. It's basically the star shape. It's the minimum requirement. Also fill in the gaps between pistons like this. And then I also did fill up those gaps on top of all of those blocks and also on this piston arm. Like this. Let's also do it on the other side. Let's fill all of those blocks and top of the piston arm. And this basically makes sure that a lot of those chorus flowers would get collected. So we have basically two holes where the items could fall through, and a lot of them are really collected by this water stream right here. Alright, so next step is powering those pistons or connecting it to the clock at the bottom. So for this I'm just gonna take out those concrete blocks for now, so we don't power the pistons all the time if you do some changes in front of the observer right here. So here we're gonna place just some radials and add the part here at the bottom. So you just go out like this. You need to create a pulse with a certain pulse length. So repeater on 2 ticks. And you make this pulse extender with the comparator in the middle. And redstone dust on the top. Here we add another power rail or activator rail on the side. Server detects this activator rail, powers this block. And here we also need a certain pulse length of 6 redstone ticks. So that's why you put normal repeater on 2 ticks powering the rail and another one powering the block which powers the repeater on 4 ticks. And here we need to do the same. 4 ticks and 2 ticks. Also here we need a 4 tick redstone repeater and here the same. Oh, here's a 1 tick, sorry. So this 4, yeah, that's correct, 4 ticks and total 5 ticks, but this one has to be in 4, that's important. And like this. So now it's all wired up. So before I add more layers, you can check if you build everything correctly. Place a chorus flower and as you can see it would work. Of course it wouldn't be very efficient, that's why I really want to repeat the pattern up to the sky limit. Also what's noteworthy is that you really want to place the chorus flower by aiming on the left of the or right of the block, because if you have a stem then you could place another chorus flower against it. This is basically what happens. So first 0 tick in the block would look like this for a single game tick. And that's enough, so you would be able to place another flower right there. So that's why you want to aim the side, but it's not possible to do this. So after we've built this up to sky limit, just need to contain the chorus flower. That's why I added some blocks on the top, so they don't hop out to the side. If you have a second player, which would stand right here and house it with an efficiency 3 haste 2x is enough. To instant break them, that's also an option. On the Cycraft server we even gave the chorus flower an option to grow an additional flower just by punching out those blocks here on the side and adding some more blocks in the back right here. This gives them enough place to grow actually, so like this. And then there's a 10% chance that a second flower would generate. We also need to go one to the back and then there's a chance that a second flower would generate, and it would even make a plus of cross flowers in a two-player farm if you do it like this. I also added a little roof here to reduce the number of skylight updates you get from moving opaque blocks. So thanks a lot for watching, I hope this tutorial was useful for you, have a nice day, bye bye!